She's the acid tongue temptress, big on front and earrings, and she's taken Weatherfield by storm.
Never forget.
In just 4 years, she's been catapulted from obscurity to national fame, winning Britain's Best Actress Award earlier this year.
And thanks for everyone who voted. Goodbye, thanks.
But now, Suranne Jones, better known as Karen MacDonald, is leaving the street that made her famous. The cobbles trembled and grown men ran for cover. We look back at her turbulent years.
Get me back! I'm flipping Josie!
Talk to Suranne about her life as Corrie Bad Girl Karen.
She did lots of this and pulling her face and kind of flirting with everyone and winking with everyone and snogging everybody, really.
And we get the lowdown on what she's doing next.
I want to buy myself some nice dusters and some nice cloths and like a mop and a bucket. I'm going to clean my house like it's never been cleaned.
Action! We take you behind the scenes of her final dramatic exit.
Next week we'll be going Karen
who? Oh, you bitch.
And find out what her fellow Corrie cast really think of her.
I won't miss the way she smells.
Karen MacDonald is a Weatherfield wench supersized. That's how I'd describe Karen MacDonald. She plays it with a kind of music hall meets Broadway bombast, with snot ringing down her nose.
Trailer trash. Can I say that?
I enjoy her most when she's just being funny, or pouring drinks over people's heads, or doing that.
She's just got such balls. She's a proper Northern lass, and she's in that fantastic mould of Coronation Street women, the Elsie Tanners, it's the tart with a heart or the fish white with a heart that you absolutely love. And you just think, what's she going to do next? I've got to switch on the telly. What's Karen up to now?
Karen Phillips arrived on the street in June 2000 when her mate Linda Sykes landed her a job at Underworld. Rough as a bear's bottom, Karen got off to a quiet start. Before long, naughty knickers were the order of the day.
Mike, this is Karen. She's good. We're very lucky to have her.
She's already given you the big build-up, Karen, but I'd like to see what you can do for myself.
My first scene, I kind of did all my lines like this. My first scene, and I couldn't really get them out properly. And they went, no, come on now. This is OK. This is your character. Next minute, I suddenly found her. And that's where Karen was born, and she did lots of this and pulling her face and kind of flirting with everyone and winking with everyone and snogging everybody, really.
When Suranne first started, we had to do a kissing scene, which was in Steve's flat, which was, like, above the taxi office.
You're not talking.
Am I just?
With her being very nervous, I don't really think she knew exactly what to do, so it was more of a kind of read-through. It wasn't even, like, a proper rehearsal. We were just kind of blocking the scene. And, yeah, she kind of dove in, straight in there, blah. Like this. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Chill out, love.
It was an absolute dream come true to kind of realise that, you know, this was a gift of her character, really.
She may give this impression she's as tough as an old Prada boot, but underneath it all, you can just see it just simmering gently away, you know, that she's a softie at the end of the day.
Sometimes it's the nastiest, hardest people who are actually the most vulnerable because they're so frightened of being hurt because they've been hurt at some point in their life that actually it's like, you know, attack is the best form of defence.
Oh! Cheated! 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 It's a spot! Oh! Working with Simon Gregson's great because you've got the opportunity there to go and work with your best friend and have a giggle and talk and gossip and I get to throw things at him and I get to punch him and trip him up and shout and scream at him and kiss him and jump on him and all these great things that we just have an absolute ball doing.
Suranne was the world's worst person to be given a prop to throw. I was constantly injured doing scenes.
All right, now! Is that your last word on it?
Yes.
Really?
Really?
Right, well, how about this, then, eh?
Whoa!
stupid woman!
Because we had such a good kind of relationship, it was kind of by accident we were doing scenes, and they were kind of funny and very kind of Jack and Vera-ish, you know. So it was decided that she would take the kind of dominant role and I'd be like the subservient, badly treated boyfriend, you know. And it kind of went from there, really. And it was just there. So the writers loved it and jumped on it, and the rest is history kind of thing.
Not Flaming Romeo, you know.
Spotting the potential for a new Curry double act, the scriptwriters came up with a unique way of getting them together. The factory girls bet Karen that she couldn't get Steve to propose. Karen took them on, told Steve, and offered him a 50-50 split of the winnings. But no one thought they'd go through with it.
Oh, I never.
Flaming egg.
Yeah, mate. Karen, we haven't known each other long enough. So will you marry me?
I don't believe it.
Yeah.
The soap operas are so bizarre anyway, you know what I mean? It won't be long till there's ghosts and aliens in the thing, you know what I mean? So it was no big shock, but it was something quite bizarre like that.
As far as I'm concerned, Steve and Karen absolutely belong together. They are classic Corrie couples in the Hilda Ogden and Stan Ogden tradition, and they should always be together. It's only ever right when the two of them are together, be it at loggerheads or be it in each other's arms.
I don't know what to say.
Well, I think they tell you what to say, we just got to repeat it.
So we're really going to go through with it then?
They actually get to the point where they're in the registry office and they're standing opposite each other. All the girls have clacked out of Wonderworld to go down to see if they're actually going to do it. And they're put in this unenviable position where they're facing each other in front of their pals and they've got to go through with it.
I think Ali was definitely shocked when they got married for a bit. I mean, who wouldn't be? You know, and not only that, Eileen had to hand over her own ring during the ceremony because they didn't even have a ring.
Yeah, you can borrow mine. Stop.
Come here, Eileen.
Be careful.
Thank you.
Appalling behaviour. Disgraceful.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my commitment to our marriage.
I'm acting the vows, but I couldn't say them. Like, dead nervous. Oh, well, I was going, I can't do it, I'm sorry.
He said, I don't like doing this, it's all a bit funny, doing marriage scenes. So you're actually marrying me, Simon, it's fine.
I promise to love, cherish, honour and respect you.
Better get the calculator out.
What a wonderful way to get a partner. Because if she had actually dated Steve properly, if she'd gone through all that rigmarole and then he'd turned around and said, on your bike, girl, she would have really been devastated because it would have confirmed for her she wasn't a nice person, she wasn't that good. But, of course, if she can do it on a bet, then if it doesn't work out, she'll go, well, it was only a bet anyway. And so it was kind of a way for her to get into a relationship, which underneath it all is something Karen desperately, desperately craves.
She can't actually believe that he's with her, you know, because he's like the hunk of the street and, you know, Karen's just my Steve, my Steve, my Steve, my Steve all the time. You know, that's all she says. Steve, my Steve, you know, that's it. She just reiterates his name all the time to make sure that she's, you know, they're together. It's really, really sweet. Really sweet.
Karen, I love you. Oh, God, I've done it now, haven't I?
You love me?
Yeah.
And of you too.
It kind of met his match, really, I think. And he liked it, so he fell in love and he told her so. So that was that. Ah, soft git.
Coming up after the break, we're talking brawn.
Everyone thinks that Karen ran off with Joe. She had bloody good reason to run off with Joe.
We're talking bombshell.
Is who the real father is? And that horrid, horrid, horrid Tracy Barlow came in and ruined it all.
And babies.
What are you having?
A baby. And she says, oh, I'm a Baron Karen. Actually, I'm Shelley Sproggs. How about that, Tracy?
It's your party, and you're allowed one little wish.
George!
Ciao.
No martini?
you're allowed two little wishes. What would you wish for?
When you had diarrhea this morning, you had a choice. Did you hope it might go away by itself? Or did you take Imodium Plus? Why risk upsetting the rest of your day? Take Imodium. Take control.
Engine technology, better pictures, whatever you're watching.
Home cinema with a difference. From tiny.com, a high quality 42 inch plasma screen for under £1,000. Or enjoy the total cinema package. Add detachable stereo speakers, a spectacular 5.1 surround sound system, and DVD player, all less than half price. Only £1,299 in the tiny.com sale. Tiny cut out the middlemen to bring you more. Order direct from tiny.com or call into the computer shop. Sale now on.
With a magnet kitchen, you can get smart space solutions built in. So as well as the style you want, you get the space you need. Fabulous designs. Great innovations. And our unique full-circle service. It all adds up to a kitchen that's designed around you. Magnet. Winter sale now on.
The Argos up to half price sale is now on. There's some incredible deals like this large leather sofa now under half price for only £299 with free delivery.
Tarquin's on his way.
How did you persuade me to do this?
Your love, Tarquin. He's big. In digestive health. To Tarquin, friendly bacteria's for life. Tarquin.
Fancy life of friendly bacteria.
By the age of 7, most cats would have jumped thousands of times, which means a lot of action for the joints. But don't change how you treat her. Try new IAMS Active Maturity 7 Plus, a complete, everyday food that supports healthy joints. That helps your cat stay active throughout life. IAMS. Good for active joints. Good for life.
While you're asleep, your cravings don't bother you. That's why Nicolette's 16-hour patch is designed to keep the cravings at bay, only while you're awake. Nicolette's 16-hour patch. Because your cravings don't bother you when you're asleep.
Make your Yule cool. With a festive season of Arnie Classics on ITV2. Starting with Red Heat, tonight at 9.
Be strong.
You made me look all right, Muppet!
The honeymoon's over for the MacDonalds. After just 2 years as husband and wife, their marriage is on the rocks. And Karen's about to get a new partner. In crime.
Another girl.
You're driving me mad!
Still, it's only another 6 hours until you see him again.
There's not a lot I can do about that, Steve, because he's my boss!
Enter stage left, Joe Carter, of course, suave, sophisticated, and a little bit of a devil, it's fair to say, with an eye for the ladies.
I think that it'd be a crying shame for a gorgeous woman like you to go to sleep alone tonight.
They were in this hotel together, and she was very tempted, but Karen adores Steve, which is the whole
point of their relationship, and she would never have done anything. She likes the flirt and she likes the chase, and she almost did it, but then she said, no, I'm going to get a cab home, I'm going to go and see my Steve.
Back in Weatherfield, Steve's jealousy has got the better of him, and thinking Karen was being unfaithful, he set out to get even. Before long, the man she loved and trusted had betrayed her.
What he does is gets himself a little bit soddled with some tramp that he meets in a bar. And, of course, Karen later discovers his treachery.
Who's been in this bed?
No one.
She can cry like that, you know. She can either do the full tears or she can just let one tear go down. She's kind of like got an internal tap to her eyes, you know, she like switches it on.
Don't lie to me, it's written all over your face!
And I think that's probably where it began to unravel for Steve and Karen. Perhaps that was the point of no return, because obviously the trust, which they'd always had between them, had finally fractured.
If we can't trust each other, then we've got nothing now, Kurt. Out of my way.
But you can't trust me. It was a one-off,
no,
I swear.
Get out of my way.
I think when we watch Coronation Street and we see Karen and Steve together, we recognise people we know. And I think that's why we warm to this situation, to Karen, to Steve, to the whole scenario, because we know that it's actually true to life.
But it isn't real life. It's soap. So after a quickie divorce, Steve got down on one knee and proposed again. This time, for love.
Will you marry me?
Yeah.
Wedding number two for the MacDonalds, the biggest soap had ever seen. Karen wanted the fairy tale with no expense spared, and the whole street turned out to witness the happy day.
Karen's big day was going to be just that. It would rival Posh and Beck's, make no mistake.
Karen just wanted to have the most dramatic wedding that we've ever seen in Weatherfield. You know, I think they were shipping in swans and various small forms of wildlife on the day.
Eileen thought the whole wedding was ridiculous.
She was determined to have the coach and horses, the full spread.
Steve runs a cab company at the end of the day, and she sews knickers. So God knows where they got the money from. I mean, I think Steve will be still paying that off for the rest of his life, I think.
Unfortunately, it was January, and so to film a wedding in January in a freezing cold chapel, you can actually see our breath on some of the shots, because it was so cold.
Okay, stand by to rehearse, please.
It was flipping freezing and the rain was falling down and we had these fur things and Vicky, Janice, had broken, had twisted her ankle. So along with that, we had one bridesmaid on crutches in the peeing down rain. It was a fun day.
It was the biggest talking point of the whole street, but not quite in the way that she planned, bless her.
The wedding of the year was about to get a whole lot more dramatic for the bride and groom. 14 million viewers tuned in to see Tracy Barlow shatter Karen's dreams.
I felt so sorry for Karen, because it was Karen's, like, day, a perfect day, and that horrid, horrid, horrid Tracy Barlow came in and ruined it all.
Tracy Barlow, lurking like a gargoyle in the background, suddenly makes her presence known, parts the congregation, of course, and drops the bombshell that Amy is actually Steve's daughter. And that moment on Karen's face is vintage Corrie.
This is who the real father is! Bridegroom! Steve! Not Roy Cropper! Well, aren't you? Go on, tell her!
What did you just say?
Things I love about Karen is that she's so sort of pretty to look at, but then when Steve's done something wrong, i.e. he's gone to talk to Tracy or gone down to London, she has that look. And you just know it's the bulldog swallowing the wasp, and it's like, Steve, MacDonald, just you wait till I get you home.
I think I'd die if I ever kind of really watched myself and what my face does. It contorts itself into a completely different person when Karen's mad. And she does all this, and she does that, and she does this. Oh, God, because I, like, carried away.
What did she say?
I said, Steve, that you're marrying is the baby's father.
You lying little whore.
Well, then why don't you ask him, Karen? Go on.
The way Suranne portrayed Karen in that was just, her acting was, it was just, you could hear a pin drop in that church. It was brilliant, brilliant acting.
All in all, it took 3 weeks, and by the end I wanted to burn that wedding dress because I was just like so sick of putting it on. Because everyone said, oh God, it must be great to film a wedding because you get to be like the belle of the ball. And I said, yeah, for the first week it's great to go in and put your wedding dress on and get your hair done. And then, like, by the third week, everyone's really tired and I'm kind of hitting people away who's trying to put my rollers back in. I'm going, get off, all right. You know, just give me the shoe while I smack Tracy, you know.
Karen, don't make it worse.
How can this be any worse?
Because she means it. When it comes to screwing money out of people, she does it very well.
Oh, as opposed to just screwing people.
Karen had Tracy up with the stiletto. And literally, if I hadn't, I had to move at exactly the right time because the stiletto came and smacked me over the head. And if I, it would have hit me in the face if I hadn't bobbed down at exactly the right time. So yeah, that was another moment where my heart was in my mouth a little bit. Because I mean, that wouldn't have been good, would it?
Karen and Steve finally did make it up the aisle, but her dreams of a perfect wedding and marriage were not to be. She was at war with Tracy Barlow. Steve had a love child living just across the street.
Just me and you then, eh?
And then her unhappy past came back to haunt her.
Yes.
Karen's parents had rejected her in her teenage years, and when her father turned up with the news that her mother was dying, we learnt more about the disturbed child behind the brash exterior.
This man disowned me. Told me never to darken his doorstep again. And wasn't there something about me burning in hell?
Well, the more reason to drop by and bury the hatchet then, eh?
He isn't here to apologise.
I've got nothing to apologise for.
Well, then what are you here for? Do you want another crack at saving me? Just take a look around you. I'm a lost cause. And I'm proud of it.
The memories she has of her mother are the memories of fighting and having to leave and all of that, and that's all she'll ever have. And suddenly, you know, when you look at her father, it's too painful. Just go. Just get out of my life, you know. Don't remind me of the pain that I've been through, and don't remind me that I haven't got a family. And when Cara's mother died, that was horrendous because they never made peace. It's like being an adult orphan. There is no possibility to change the end of your story. The person is not there.
I know that it's too late, but what I realise is that she just wanted me to be a good person.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's the way that she went about things. That's why I hated her. She was always telling me I was bad. You know, that is all I can remember her ever saying to me, how bad I was. And the more she said it, the more I thought, yeah. Well, you just watch. I'll show you what bad is.
I thought it was lovely to actually delve into Karen's past. And I think perhaps if Karen or Suranne Jones had stayed around, we could have explored that more and more over the years. That would have been lovely. Karen's history.
But Karen was looking to the future, moving on, making plans, and babies.
And I'm going to draw us up a timetable.
With what?
Of when I'm ovulating. I mean, it's dead easy. I take my temperature when I'm hot and ready. Oh, that's when you come in.
What, you really know how to make a bloke feel special?
Karen definitely wanted that baby as soon as possible. So she was just not going to stop until she was pregnant.
Come on now. Let's go to bed.
Hang on. I thought you just said you were still angry with me.
Yeah, I am. But we haven't tried for a baby for 3 days now.
I'm getting mixed messages here, Karen.
Well, according to my chart, this is the most fertile time of the month and we should be doing it at least 10 times a night.
You what? I was a...
Don't argue with me, Steve! Just come on! Got a lot of work to do.
Steve had to put a lot of work in to get that baby. It was like 10 times a day. Crikey. You'll have every woman in the country going like that. Well, no. 10 times a day turning. Only in soap.
How was it for you?
Necessary.
Steve's hard work finally paid off.
What are you having?
A baby. Are you deaf, Daddy?
Shh. she has been desperate for a child. And you know why? Because when you have your own baby, so many women feel that the world can disintegrate about them, that their husbands will leave them, but once they have a baby, there's someone there that will love them. So suddenly her dreams come true. She's pregnant. She's got Steve. She's got the baby. It's fantastic.
Lad's name? Jack.
Jack Duckworth? You behave. I want something people aren't going to forget.
Ronald.
Unfortunately, Karen being Karen, she, you know, goes to Tracy and she says, oh, I'm a Baron Karen. Actually, I'm Shelley Sproggs. How about that, Tracy?
Oh, Tracy! Aren't they just to die for? I mean, I've splashed out a bit, but I am so excited about being pregnant. Couldn't help myself. Got your heart set on a girl, then? Thought Steve might have wanted one of each. Steve isn't bothered what we have, as long as it's ours.
But Karen's dreams were short-lived. At the Underworld Christmas party, she started to lose the baby.
When Karen has her miscarriage, it is the last straw. Is it any surprise that it tips her over the edge, that suddenly she's lost control? Because all that pain that she feels is now right on the surface, and it hurts. It hurts a lot. And that's where Karen's at the moment.
These scenes are so sad, because she really wanted it as well. She so wanted it, and all her dreams and her hopes and everything that, you know, was going to make her life better had gone.
It detects a heartbeat.
Does it? Have you found one?
I mean, that's what it's for.
And have you found one?
And obviously you want to kind of like portray this in a truthful and caring way as well, because obviously, you know, it's absolutely heartbreaking for people that have been through this.
He's gone, hasn't he?
I'm afraid you've miscarried.
After the break, it's the final showdown in the war between Karen and Tracy. Join us as we go behind the scenes to catch all the action and reveal the glamorous secrets of working on Britain's best loved soap.
This is like, now something different. It's like being in a film.
Okay, I need to get you in and get you makeup on, thank you.
At the PC World sale, there's £150 off this Packard Bell PC, TFT monitor, recordable DVD for only
$4.49. Drambuie, please.
Drambuie is crafted with aged malt whiskies and a recipe kept secret since 1745.
With a magnet kitchen, you can get smart space solutions built in. So as well as the style you want, you get the space you need. Fabulous designs. Great innovations. And our unique full-circle service. It all adds up to a kitchen that's designed around you. Magnet. Winter sale now on.
Be faster? With Wanadoo, go twice as fast as BT Broadband for just £17.99 a month. Visit wanadoo.co.uk for details.
To save energy, use just enough water to cover your vegetables. The same applies when taking a bath.
Positive energy from PowerGen.
When you come on holiday to Ireland, remember, we've got the odd ghost or two. So you better bring the family. Safety in numbers. Oh, and while you're at it, bring a fishing rod. Maybe even a saddle. Or two. You can do a lot in Ireland. Or relax with a few friends. Stay in a self-catering cottage or a luxurious castle in Ireland, the Island of Memories. Why not give us a call or visit theislandofmemories.co.uk.
This is the nearest
Are we crazy?
To crazy I have ever known.
Designer sofas.
I was never crazy on my own.
Reduced in price.
And now I know.
Not once. But twice. Are we crazy? No. We're DFS. And our double discount sale is on all this bank holiday.
Lemsip's new Sinus 12-hour product is the only one to help treat sinus pressure pain and congestion for up to 12 hours. Lemsip, let's get on with life.
Hello, my name is Sue Taylor. I've been smoking for 12 years. And I have come to the stage now where I think it's becoming really disgusting. I spend all my money on it, even though I don't have a lot. It's never a question of cigarettes or this or that or the other. It's cigarettes. So I decided that it's time for me to stop smoking. It's not going to be easy. I do know that much.
Be strong and quit with nicotine.
Be strong.
Baby Amy is missing, and Tracy thinks Karen has killed her. She's out for revenge, and in an explosive storyline, she changes life in Weatherfield forever.
Tracy! Tracy!
You can't sustain characters like that in that close proximity. You just can't have them around, and poor Steve in the middle, and it had to end how it's ended.
Tracy!
Tracy's search for Karen brings her back to Coronation Street, where tonight the cast and crew are filming the final scenes that build to Karen's dramatic departure.
We're doing the scene where Tracy's gone to the Red Wreck and she's seen that the people carrier's on fire, and she presumes that Karen has killed Amy because she can see the car seat. It's been this bitch has killed Amy, and I think so. Tracy goes completely like a wild woman and comes to kill Karen. That's the scene. Like, you know, it's normal everyday life, and yeah.
Mind the road, guys, please. Car coming up the road, thanks. So stand clear then, but cue the rain, thank you.
Those words, cue the rain, are going to haunt me for the rest of my life. Because, like, in my ignorance, I thought, well, the rain won't be that cold, you know, it might be heated up slightly, but no, of course not, because then it gets steam and also freezing, freezing cold.
It's coming out of the ground absolutely freezing cold. There's been no way we could warm this water up in the time that is required, so we have to give it to them as nature would. And how they've been rolling around it, I don't know. As I say, I've got this protective waterproof gear on here, with a hood on, and I'm still getting soaked, believe me.
Here we go then, for rehearsal, stand by, and action.
The writers have done an amazing job where they've just built this relationship up where Karen and Tracy have finally come to a head, and one of Kate's lines is, tonight we cross the line, and something has happened, and someone's got to go, basically.
Filming such sensational scenes involves a massive crew. As well as the special effects experts, there are teams from makeup and costume, plus two cameras, four sound engineers, one director, and two stunt artists.
I'm standing in for the Suranne. I don't know, it's her name, that's terrible, isn't it? But I know that it's Karen MacDonald.
Yeah, I'm doubling Kate, who's Tracy, tonight. I'm trying to kill Suranne, or my partner Eunice tonight. Just chasing her down the street, you know, crashing into walls. Hopefully trying to get her, but she's a bit quick, even in heels.
We're just going to do a near miss down this end, and I'm just going to dive into a puddle. Very nice.
What I'd like in a perfect world is her to be moving at you, which causes you to stop because she's coming back.
Okay, good.
She mounts the pavement, that's the moment of alarm, what's occurring?
Then I start moving.
Straight back again. Back here, and as she comes at you, she'll be timing it so you fall in the doorway as the car comes swinging past
you. Yeah.
Okay?
It is important that you've got to dot every I and cross every T, because if an artist gets it wrong, we just go again, they've got their lines wrong. If a stunt person gets it wrong, you're into potential tragedy, and that's the last thing we want. So I want to know exactly what the camera angles are. I can then foreshorten the distance, I can put the artists in, and all these things have to be talked and walked and discussed beforehand. And it is time consuming, you've got to do it. If she makes the far corner, slam into the car.
Got it.
You're happy?
Yeah, great.
Any questions?
No. Don't do anything so complicated that, you know, she's the back or whatever.
Oh, give me a challenge. Don't do a backflip.
Thank you, I would like to watch the floor. Thank you.
It may be Karen and Tracy's scene, but Suranne and Kate are nowhere near the action. The stunt doubles film all the wide shots, with the real actors just stepping in for close-ups.
Still, please, here we go. Stand by and action.
Once it's edited, you'd never be able to tell. The director, Terry, is happy, and so it's on to the next scene and the next stunt.
If I can get Bob...
Is the camera tip?
Yes, up there, please.
Eunice, we'll bounce off this car. Give us a beat so they can do the internals and eye-to-eye between the actresses after. She runs up the steps and tries to take refuge in Underworld. Tracy, or me, will drive right into the steps, just missing her, so hopefully we'll have a really close shot of the front of the car and Eunice's feet on this shot. She makes it to safety.
We're going to try and do a Cinderella shot and she loses a shoe on the stairs.
You come in and do that, sharp on the brakes, so we get a nice bounce on those headlamps. Okay.
Rotary core, please, and key the rein, thanks.
Despite having a stunt double, Suranne still has to throw herself on the ground and roll around in the rain. But she's not complaining. She's loving it.
I've got knee pads and elbow pads on, and I don't know, I'm just being... it's like playing out in the rain and being taught how to fall. It's like in a park when I was a kid, only this is serious stuff. And Tracy's on the rampage in the car, and I'm scared and wet.
I think Suranne has coped exceptionally well. I've got to say, she's a pro, she's great. She's slung herself down in that corner half a dozen times. She never bat an eyelid, never complained. When it came to shooting, we took the pad out and she was hitting the deck again and again and again.
So the next shot is Tracy driving in. This will be Kate driving.
Fine. Stinks this car when it gets hot. Doesn't it? The burning rubber light smell.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1...
Tracy in the car, she was smashing. A little bit nervous to start with, I've got to say. She was slightly nervous. I chatted to her a little bit, sat with her in the car, ran it through and just helped her to relax. And once she got the feel of it, she really started to enjoy it. And that's what it's all about. You're enjoying it, you relax, you do it better.
It's been a long kind of slow burner, really. It's been going on for about a year and a half, so this is the end, you know, it crosses the line here, and they couldn't get any worse than it does tonight.
But it's not the end just yet. Karen makes it to the safety of Underworld, helped by an unlikely hero.
Super Haley. She's there for everyone. Honestly, this is always the case, though. If you remember, I've smashed windows open with suitcases to save Roy's life before now.
actually in Underworld fixing Claire's wedding dress when this happens. So I'm already being a hero without the whole log incident. So no, it's like, she goes from strength to strength.
Okay, so could we pick it up? The door, you've gone through and you've closed the door behind you, but you'll need to open it and check.
And Karen ran off because she's absolutely frightened to death.
Camera seeing you from outside, silhouette.
Because she's got a massive lock. And she's chucking her nail out, which is really tight. How can you chuck her nail out? She's only trying to help.
Oh, good God.
With the cut shoes on.
Yeah. It's always fantastic when there's like big drama, driving rain, logs. It always makes you feel like you're part of something a bit excited, a bit special. So it's great. I'm absolutely loving it.
She did it all right. So where is she?
Don't know.
I think you better go, Hayley. Between me and her, then.
No, I'm gone.
Get out! No, Tracy! No, Tracy, please! Please, Tracy!
Guys?
By the time it hits your TV screen, it all looks very dramatic.
Tracy,
whatever's happened, whatever you two are arguing
it's
about
more
this time.
Than an argument.
Just let me in.
No, calm down first.
No!
Calm down and we can talk about it properly. She's a pregnant woman.
Not anymore, Hayley. She lost her baby. She lost her baby, so she stole mine. She stole Amy and she killed her. She killed Amy.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, is this true?
Right. Where is she?
Are you sure about this?
Yes. She stole the car, Hayley. And Amy was in the back. And she set fire to it. Now, where is she?
I don't know.
It's between me and her now, Hayley, so you better go.
No, come on, hang on.
Mom, just get out! Oh, Jason, please.
I don't think Hayley can save the day. I think it's out of her hands now. As soon as she got pushed out of those factory doors, she was back in dithering mode. She'd done everything she could. She'd used all her strength, but that was it. So it's in the lap of the gods now.
Despite Hayley's super efforts, Karen and Tracy end up on the roof of Underworld.
My husband!
There's only one man who can save them now.
What is it with you two? Why, dear, why do we always end up like this?
You were there, Steve. You saw what she did. Why are you protecting her?
Because he loves me and he hates you.
Shut up! And you, Amy, is down there.
Steve's the peacemaker all the time. So he is, you know, he's always... try to make peace between the pair of them, and he's, you know, the guy who's always in the middle saying, right, well, I know how you're feeling, and, you know, you shouldn't do this either, and blah, 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 you know, and in the end he's just gone bang and just said, look, forget it, you know, I've had enough.
Oh, Steve, she's going to kill me if you hadn't turned up.
I wanted to throw you off the flaming roof myself.
Even in the last scenes, you know, myself and Kate said, you can tell that these girls don't want to be doing this to each other now because it's gone too far. And they'd get on like house on fire if the circumstances were different. But great characters, great, great strong characters who you just love to hate.
It's all right, it's all right. Let's get you home.
Back on the street, it's home time for the cast and crew. It's been a long but successful shoot.
Ladies and gents, we've run out of time, I'm afraid. We have to call it a day there. That's a wrap for today. Thank you very much for all the hard work today.
A bit hoarse from all the shouting. Trained actress. Very well trained. And, but no, I'm okay. I've got my hot water bottle and I'm going on to my bed now. So.
Coming up, it's farewell to Karen and goodbye to Suranne. We're on the street for her final scene. and her closest friends reveal the secrets of one of Britain's most popular actresses.
She's the most beautiful woman. Then she gives a... Oh, I'm sorry. She's got terrible flatulence problems.
There are some amazing deals in the Argos up to half price sale. Save £800 on our lowest ever price 42-inch plasma TV, now under £1,000.
How could Harvey's possibly make this three-seater sofa even more gorgeous? Easy. They've made it half price, then taken an extra 10% off. In fact, everything in the sale, including this leather sofa, is half price plus an extra 10% off. So, guess what they've done with these? Yep. Made them half price and taken an extra 10% off. It's Harvey's biggest ever furniture sale.
Harvey sale, now on at 170 stores nationwide.
Save energy, use just enough water to cover your vegetables. The same applies when taking a bath.
Positive energy from PowerGen.
Tarquin's on his way.
How did you persuade me to do this?
You'll love Tarquin. He's big. In digestive health. To Tarquin, friendly bacteria's for life. Tarquin.
Fancy a life of friendly bacteria?
Right now at B&Q, we've more kitchens in stock with half-price doors than ever before. Different designs and finishes to suit your style. With half-price doors, this oak-style kitchen is now only £1,284. Kitchen offers at prices too low to miss.
The PC World sale has just begun with amazing two-day specials for today and tomorrow. Plus thousands more savings right across the store.
At WH Smith, our biggest ever half-price sale is now on. Oh, come on, let's go.
For clothes that are gentle on skin. Ariel Non-Bio.
Now, with every McDonald's Happy Meal, there's a free child cinema ticket to see Disney Pixar's new movie.
Showtime.
The Incredibles.
I love it!
While you're asleep, your cravings don't bother you. That's why Nicorette's 16-hour patch is designed to keep the cravings at bay, only while you're awake. Nicorette's 16-hour patch. Because your cravings don't bother you when you're asleep.
Be strong.
It's Christmas Day on Coronation Street, a peaceful and joyous time for the residents of Weatherfield, but not in the MacDonald household.
I saw Jack and Vera arguing in the street on the way here. She threw him out. You know what they're like? Arguing like cat and dog. But you couldn't imagine either of them with anybody else. In the end, one of them would die in the other one's arms. I'll put money on it. I used to think me and you were like them.
We are?
Difference is, the They were arguing over a £1.99 second-hand Christmas card.
It's the saddest, saddest scenes that I've ever played in that show. Because you can't help just thinking, God, this is where it's come to, and, you know, and they're so loved. Karen and Steve are so loved, and people don't want them to split up, and this isn't what people want to happen. But the way it's been written, people will totally understand why he's got to kind of let her go. Because she does, she needs help, and it's very, very sad.
We love each other.
Oh, I do love you, Karen.
Well, then...
I just can't live with you anymore. It's not healthy. It's not healthy for either of us or anybody else around us.
I just burst into tears. That doing this scene, like, properly cried, and it was like, where did that come from? You know, so it was weird, but it looked great. So we carried on with it, and we did really get really into it, really emotionally, you know, which was a first for me, really.
So you are going to let Tracy win? You're going to allow her to wreck this match?
This has got nothing to do with Tracy or Amy. I'm finishing with you for my own sanity.
There were real tears, and, you know, it wasn't kind of technically done. It was all very high on emotion that day.
So I'm sorry, you're just gonna have to go.
For a take, stand by. And action.
It's the end of the road for the MacDonalds and the end of Karen's time in Weatherfield. Before she leaves, Suranne must film her exit scene, one of the most exciting and emotional moments of all her time on Coronation Street.
It's very dark and it's very cold, and the street is absolutely covered in a blanket of snow. And one of the best exits I think I've ever seen on the street. It's very up there with Elsie Tanner leaving the street. Or Bette Lynchy leaving the street, which is quite right, because Karen MacDonald is a Coronation Street icon as far as I'm concerned. She has a very fitting leaving, very classic Coronation Street, not to be missed.
We think the writers might have written Shelley in.
Oh, no.
Because we're best mates.
Because there's no reason why Shelley
would be.
I should be in this scene. I think they're just doing it
with your funny hat on and your coach.
We were in tears after that scene, and the fabulous irony of not real life is that Shelley doesn't give a monkey's whether Karen's there or not, to be honest. All she does is cause trouble in a pub, so if she's not there, then fantastic. No, you know, one less factory girl to chuck out, really. But obviously, you know, in real life, it's me and Suranne, you know, parting company in work, obviously, but which is a very sad thing.
This wonderful scene that when I saw it on paper, it made me cry instantly. And I had, as an actress, a very, very proud feeling of where I've brought this character to and what I've done with her.
Keep the snow, please.
Off she goes, in the snow. So, yeah, it is quite sad. In fact, most of the cast, the girls in the cast were reading it and crying in the green room, going, oh, it's going to be really sad. But they were right, it is.
I'm going to cry buckets next. Buckets. And then next week we'll be going, Karen, who?
Oh, you bitch.
I turned up because I absolutely wanted to see her do her final bit, and it did make me go a bit goosebumpy watching her stood with her hand on her hip saying bye to it. It was just a massive moment, and you know, and I'm nosy. That's basically the reason I'm nosy. I wanted to see what was happening. I wanted to see the snow on Coronation Street, and it was freezing cold, absolutely freezing cold. And about 1:30 in the morning, I must have been mad, but anyway, I turned up, gagging in. Hiya. She was pleased, I think. She better have been pleased. What, I'm going to miss her.
Oh, do that again.
Ooh, that's unusual.
Ooh, said you were gay.
Ooh,
lovely.
Ooh, what did they call that? Isn't that unusual?
Bye. Well, I liked it.
As much as they love her, there are some things that the cast won't miss.
I won't miss the way she smells. I've never known a girl fart so much in my life. And she's got the smelliest feet of anyone I've ever known.
She's badly behaved. She's naughty. She eats like a horse. She's the most beautiful woman. Then she gives it... Oh, I'm sorry.
She'll kill me for that. Okay, then.
I'm going to miss not being able to walk into that green room every day and not being able to see Sam and Gregson. And, Kate and all my friends. Because it's been 4.5 years of my life and it's just been amazing, and it's going to be like, for a while at least, like I've had my arm chopped off.
I wanted to give Suranne a fantastic sending off, because she is the life and the soul of the party, and so we wanted a fantastic leaving do. So I came up with the idea of having a Karen MacDonald lookalike party, and it went absolutely really well. I was really chuffed. Half the cast came as Karen.
Hi, Dave.
Hello. Hi, yeah. What do you think?
I'll certainly, as Kate, will miss Karen, and I'll miss doing Tracy scenes with Karen so much, you know, because we just had such a laugh. You know, working together and the scenes, I found I enjoyed doing them because it was just, she was my sparring partner, and also Saran's really good fun to work with, so on both sides, I'll miss working with Saran.